Romania provided 3 infantry battalions, 1 air defense battalion, 1 artillery battalion of 220 personnel. Each unit is
soul of a unit. In every military organization, the commander, soldiers, equipment, and missions change. There is no real permanence to a military organization except for the colors.
U.S. Army Europe is doing a fantastic job of supporting NATO's mission in Europe, and this exercise is an example of that. We have great units out here building readiness every single day. We have units working with our coalition partners, building interoperability, which makes us a stronger coalition. And just the training that goes on makes a significant contribution to a strong Europe. Well, I think our contribution is about providing strength. And when our adversaries see an armored brigade combat team here, they know we're committed and they know we have the capability to support our coalition partners. Well, we're a total army, we're a total force. The active, the National Guard and Reserve are all critical parts of our force, and we bring them together here in Europe and we allow them to train together, and they all leave at a higher set of readiness, ready to go. What I'd like to say to the soldiers is we really appreciate what they're doing. We know they're away from their families for a long period of time, but they should know that what they're doing is important, what they're doing is making a difference, and they are contributing to a strong Europe.
The changes in our force posture, in the ways that we train, in our readiness, in how we think about what we need to do together, those changes have been extraordinary.
In the middle of the United States Army Europe-led exercise Saber Guardian, involving over 25,000 service members from over 20 nations, massed in the Black Sea region, and training with our partners from Hungary, Romania, and Bulgaria, supported by our incredible 4th ID Mission Command element, and just finishing a combined arms live fire, I couldn't be prouder of this brigade and every single one of its soldiers.
This is the greatest army in the world because we have the greatest soldiers in the world. Truly, from across our nation, our best men and women, I just want to say thank you for all of those times, for your service, to be there for you. You're absolutely amazing. We ask so much of you, and you always respond. I am so impressed and honored and privileged, and I'm a better person because of all of you.
And I'm grateful to be standing among members of the greatest alliance in the history of Western civilization. As a second lieutenant in Texas or a captain in Germany, I never imagined assuming BCT command in a beautiful setting like this in the middle of Romania. The long history of our NATO partners and the repeated demonstrations of commitment to each other that I have witnessed in just the last few weeks are nothing short of inspiring. The acts of cooperation and sacrifice, they should give us all a feeling of hope for the future and our commitment to the universal freedoms that every member of this alliance cherishes. And I look forward to continuing that commitment, our partnerships, and above all, building on our ability to deter any adversary, anytime, anywhere, who chooses to threaten those freedoms.